about the book press, which was a major, major printer here in Brattleboro and in the country, and employed many, many people, published top-notch books for all the major publishers in the country. So it was here till about 2000, but it had a long, about 30-year history.
Welcome to Brattleboro's printing and publishing heyday, 1900 to 1970. Mary Ide has provided a map, so you won't miss anything. Most of the exhibit is up on the mezzanine and in the history room. And then there's a book press exhibit of a very few of the many books that were printed and bound here in Brattleboro, including two Harry Potters. So. Brattleboro, as you know, has always been a book town, first known for paper making and printing, later for publishing, printing, and binding. And as many of you know, in the 50s and 60s, easily 10% of Brattleboro's population was engaged in the book trades, which was, at that time, the highest per capita percentage in the country. So, you'll see that the quality of work ranged from good to superb, and we have a few people we'd like help in identifying, including especially those two ladies at the book press sewing signatures over there. So if you have ideas about who they might be, we have a special box and forms you can fill out. Thank yous. I'd like to thank Lissa Weinman and William Edelglass for creating this monster project that inspires so many people to run around researching and saving and celebrating our history, which is amazing. Star Latronica and Jean Walsh especially, and everybody else in the library staff for their very patient, kind cooperation and help. Joe Rivers and John Carnahan at the Historical Society, Jackie, Steve, and especially John Hooper for images, research, good questions, corrections, and leads. But mostly, Mary Ide and Bill Soucy, who are a dream team. They grasp the big picture. They also focus meticulously on details. Their devotion and expertise are truly astonishing. So much of this exhibit is their work and inspiration. So have fun, look around, have an 80-point type Cookie, Palatino, of course, and consult a map and have fun. Thank you. Yeah?
Did you want to mention?
Oh, also, Bill Soucy has kindly donated a book he has reprinted on the history, a pictorial history of Brattleboro. And we are asking for a $5 donation that will go toward the Words Project. So
these photographs are from 1884.
Yeah.
So we may have changed a bit, but you can look in and see what's the same, what's new.
Good. Thank you. Thanks, Mary.
That's
thanks
a
very much.
$5.
Yeah. All right. Thank you. Have fun.
This is a book of photographs, Brattleboro from 1884, and Bill Soucy, member of the exhibit committee, has reprinted it. So if you're interested, please contact this project and we can give you, for a small donation, a copy of this book.
Thank you.
Well, I'm here at the library, along with lots of other people who have an interest in printing and publishing in Brattleboro. Once Brattleboro's largest employer, almost 20% of the people at one time were in printing and or publishing, my family included, going back to my grandfather, Howard C. Rice, started the Reformer in 1913, the Brattleboro Daily Reformer, and of course my dad was editor and publisher until his retirement in 1970. So a lot of interest here, a lot of family lore. I'm also an author for a upcoming book on printing and publishing in Brattleboro, and each of us are taking a chapter. I'm focusing on 1900 to the 1950s and doing Stephen Day Press, the Reformer, E.L. Hildreth, Vermont Printing Company, the Holstein-Friesian Company, we're also big into printing, and others, some 25 printers during that era. Called, as this tonight is called, the heyday of printing and publishing in Brattleboro.